After the bilateral talks, let's cut across live there.
Welcome you to today's ceremony where 7 documents will be exchanged. First, we have the standard operating procedure on use of Chattogram and Mongla ports. This will be exchanged on the Bangladesh side by His Excellency Mr. Syed Muazzam Ali, High Commissioner of Bangladesh to India, and on the Indian side by Sri Gopal Krishna, Secretary, Ministry of Shipping. Next, we have a MOU on withdrawal of 1.82 cusec of water from Feni River by India for drinking water supply scheme for Sabroom town in Tripura state, India. This will be exchanged on the Bangladesh side by Mr. Kabir bin Anwar, Secretary, Ministry of Water Resources, and on the Indian side by Sri Upendra Prasad Singh, Secretary, Ministry of Water Resources, Government of India. Third is an agreement concerning implementation of Government of India's line of credits extended to Bangladesh. This will be exchanged on the Bangladesh side by Mr. Muhammad Shahriar Qadir Siddiqui, Joint Secretary, Economic Relations Division, Ministry of Finance of Bangladesh, and on the Indian side by Srimati Reeva Ganguly Das, High Commissioner of India to Bangladesh. Fourth is an MOU between University of Hyderabad and University of Dhaka. This will be exchanged on the Bangladesh side by Professor Dr. Muhammad Akhtaruzzama, Vice Chancellor, University of Dhaka, and on the Indian side by Srimati Reeva Ganguly Das, High Commissioner of India to Bangladesh. We next have the renewal of the cultural exchange program between the two countries. This will be exchanged on the Bangladesh side by Dr. Abu Hena Mustafa Kamal, Secretary, Ministry of Cultural Affairs, and on the Indian side by Srimati Reeva Ganguly Das, High Commissioner of India to Bangladesh. Next is a MOU on cooperation in youth affairs. This will be exchanged on the Bangladesh side by Muhammad Akhtar Hussain, Secretary, Ministry of Youth and Sports, and on the Indian side by Srimati Reeva Ganguly Das, High Commissioner of India to Bangladesh. Finally, we have a MOU on providing coastal surveillance system. This will be exchanged on the Bangladesh side by Mr. Mustafa Kamaluddin, Senior Secretary, Ministry of Home Affairs, and on the Indian side by Srimati Reeva Ganguly Das, High Commissioner of India to Bangladesh. Excellencies, we will now witness joint remote inauguration through video conferencing of 3 bilateral projects. I request the 2 Prime Ministers to come forward in order to jointly unveil the e-plaque for inauguration of import of bulk LPG from Bangladesh.
In line with the neighborhood first policy of the government of India and to further promote India of the government of India and to further promote India Bangladesh Maitri, both the countries are taking yet another step towards mutual growth and progress. This step forward in bilateral relations would benefit Bangladesh with increased employment and trade opportunities. Bangladesh will supply LPG, liquefied petroleum gas, to northeastern region of India and transport it across the border in their LPG bullet trucks. Indian Oil's Vishalgarh bottling plant in Tripura would receive the product for further distribution. This will ensure continuous supply of LPG to the difficult terrains, even through the challenging monsoon months when roads become blocked and impassable, which will help in propagating Pradhan Mantri Ujjwala Yojana scheme in the northeastern region of India. The easier logistics with a much shorter route of 200 kilometers vis-a-vis the current circuitous route of 1700 kilometers would ensure accessibility, availability and affordability of the product. It will result in a more equitable balance of trade between the two countries and pave the way for new frontiers of expansion. This is just a beginning of a new chapter in economic growth through mutual cooperation and collaboration between India and Bangladesh. This is the second energy bridge between the two countries. The first energy bridge being the ongoing construction of India-Bangladesh Maitri Pipeline. Today, the Prime Minister of India, Shri Narendra Modi, and the Prime Minister of Bangladesh, Her Excellency, Sheikh Hasina, have come together to inaugurate the project for import of bulk LPG from Bangladesh to India. This will mark a new phase for the energy ties between the two countries.
Excellencies, I now request both the Prime Ministers to jointly unveil the e-plaq for inauguration of Bangladesh-India Professional Skill Development Institute at the Institution of Diploma Engineers Bangladesh in Khulna.
To strengthen the bilateral relationship between the Government of India and the Government of Bangladesh, signed MOU on 22nd October 2017 for setting up of Common Facility Centre for Small and Medium Enterprises at Khulna in Bangladesh under the assistance from Government of India. HMT International has set up the Bangladesh India Professional Skill Development Institute, an advanced professional skill development center in tool and die making. HMT International has set up various machining facilities at BIPSDI. The training covers basic skills, advanced skills, supervisory skills and hands-on training. 8 BIPSDI instructors are specially trained in advanced and high technology machines in India. On-the-job training to the instructors will also be given on-site on the installed machines and equipments. With this installed facilities, BIPSDI can impart training to over 200 Bangladesh youth annually through modular training. BIPSDI has the potential for employment for over 300 persons directly and indirectly and generation of $5 million business annually in view of skills generated.
Excellencies, finally I request both the Prime Ministers to jointly unveil the e-plaq for inauguration of the Vivekananda Bhavan at Ramakrishna Mission, Dhaka.
Ramakrishna Mission, Dhaka is one of the pioneer branch centers of Ramakrishna Mission, a worldwide spiritual and philanthropic organization. It has been serving the humanity in various fields, viz. Education general and technical, healthcare services, guest house, financial assistance to the poor and needy, and relief services over 100 years and more. The institution stands for a model for religious harmony. In order to serve humanity in a wider spectrum, the center constructed Vivekananda Bhavan, principally funded by the Government of India. The Bhavan is now ready for providing accommodation of 100 students, 40 guests, administrative office, reading room, library and publications. The Bhavan stands out as a milestone of friendly relationship between India and Bangladesh and represents an outstanding vision of the government of India for human resource development.
Excellencies, ladies and gentlemen, I now have the honor to request the Honorable Prime Minister of Bangladesh to deliver her remarks.
ভারতের মাননীয় প্রধানমন্ত্রী শ্রী নরেন্দ্র মোদী, ভারতের মন্ত্রিসভার মাননীয় সদস্যবৃন্দ, আমাদের বাংলাদেশের সকল সহকর্মীবৃন্দ, সম্মানিত অতিথিবৃন্দ, ভদ্রমহিলা মহোদয়গণ, আসসালামু আলাইকুম, শুভ সকাল।
আসসালামু আলাইকুম এন্ড গুড মর্নিং।
আমাকে ভারতে আমন্ত্রণের জন্য প্রথমেই আমি ভারতের মাননীয় প্রধানমন্ত্রী
At the outset, I thank the Prime Minister of India for inviting me to India. I extend gratitude to you, Prime Minister, and to your government for the warm hospitality extended to me and members of my delegation. I'm happy to be present here today for the inauguration of Vivekananda Bhavan in the Ramakrishna Mission premises in Dhaka with grant from Indian government. You know, Ramakrishna Mission has been playing a unique role in the spread of education in Bangladesh. Every year, a number of students have been continuing their education with the assistance from this institution. This institution is also working for the socio-economic development of Bangladesh. The four-storied Vivekananda Bhavan hostel will help spread the light of education amongst the students of the hostel, and the students would be inspired by the ideals of Swami Vivekananda. I thank the Government of India for providing financial assistance for this institution. The Institute of Engineers Bangladesh, located in Khulna, the establishment of Bangladesh India Professional Skill Development Institute. I'm happy to be present here today in the inauguration of this institute. The various machines provided in this institute will help in the development of the SME sector in this region and in promoting trade. Besides, this project would help in employment generation of more than 300 people. This would also help in the development of skilled human resource and in capacity building and training. This would also help in employment generation among the youth and women. The decision to import LPG from Bangladesh into India will help make the trade relations more dynamic. Besides, I hope this would help fulfill the fuel and energy demand in the northeast of India to a great extent. Distinguished guests, over the last decade, cooperation between our two countries in various traditional areas such as security, environment, energy, education, culture, people-to-people contact, health, and in various other areas, cooperation has been enhanced. Besides, in various non-traditional areas, such as blue economy and maritime affairs, peaceful uses of nuclear energy, space research, internet bandwidth, export, cyber security, cooperation in these areas have also been enhanced. This multifaceted cooperation has placed our bilateral relations as a model of good neighborliness before the world. I firmly believe this cooperation will be strengthened in the future. The trajectory of our excellent bilateral relations were unveiled in 1971 when the people of Bangladesh joined the Great Liberation War under the leadership of Father of the Nation, Bangabandhu Sheikh Mujibur Rahman. I recall with gratitude the role of the people and the government of India in the War of Liberation of Bangladesh. This would remain an eternal milestone in our bilateral relations. Distinguished guests, I thank all of you for being present here today, especially the Honorable Prime Minister Narendra Modi. Besides, I thank all who have been involved in the implementation of these projects, who have been working hard for materialization of these projects. My heartiest thanks to all of you. In future, I hope through our joint cooperation, we can inaugurate many more such development projects. My heartiest thanks to all of you. Joy Bangla, Joy Bangabandhu. May Bangladesh live forever. May Bangladesh-India friendship live forever.
Now, it is my privilege to request the Honorable Prime Minister of India to deliver his remarks.
Your Excellency, Prime Minister Sheikh Hasina ji, Excellencies, friends, Namaskar. Sobai ke sharodiyo shubhechha. मुझे खुशी है कि प्राइम मिनिस्टर शेख हसीना जी के साथ तीन और बायलेटरल प्रोजेक्ट्स का उद्घाटन करने का आज मुझे फिर एक बार मौका मिला है। पिछले एक साल में हमने वीडियो लिंक से 9 प्रोजेक्ट्स को लॉन्च किया। आज के 3 प्रोजेक्ट्स को जोड़कर एक साल में हमने 1 दर्जन ज्वाइंट प्रोजेक्ट्स लॉन्च किए हैं। इस उपलब्धि पर मैं दोनों देशों के अधिकारियों को और सभी नागरिकों को बहुत बहुत बधाई देता हूं। आज की ये 3 परियोजनाएं 3 अलग अलग क्षेत्रों में हैं। एलपीजी इंपोर्ट, वोकेशनल ट्रेनिंग और सोशल फैसिलिटी, लेकिन इन तीनों का उद्देश्य एक ही है और वो है हमारे नागरिकों के जीवन को बेहतर बनाना। यही भारत बांग्लादेश संबंधों का मूल मंत्र भी है। भारत बांग्लादेश साझेदारी का आधार है कि हमारी मित्रता से हर नागरिक का विकास सुनिश्चित हो। बांग्लादेश से बल्क एलपीजी सप्लाई दोनों देशों को फायदा पहुंचाएगी। एक प्रकार से विन विन सिचुएशन है। इससे बांग्लादेश में एक्सपोर्ट्स, इनकम और एम्प्लॉयमेंट भी बढ़ेगा। ट्रांसपोर्टेशन दूरी 1500 किलोमीटर कम हो जाने से आर्थिक लाभ भी होगा और पर्यावरण को भी नुकसान कम होगा। दूसरा प्रोजेक्ट बांग्लादेश इंडिया प्रोफेशनल स्किल डेवलपमेंट इंस्टीट्यूट, बांग्लादेश के औद्योगिक विकास के लिए कुशल मैन पावर और टेक्नीशियन तैयार करेगा। एक्सलेंसीज, लास्ट बट नॉट द लीस्ट, ढाका के रामकृष्ण मिशन में विवेकानंद भवन का प्रोजेक्ट, जो 2 महानुभावों के जीवन से प्रेरणा लेता है, हमारे समाजों और मूल्यों पर स्वामी रामकृष्ण परमहंस और स्वामी विवेकानंद जी का अमिट प्रभाव रहा है। बांग्ला संस्कृति की उदारता और खुली भावना की तरह ही इस मिशन में भी सभी पंथों को मानने वाले के लिए स्थान है और यह मिशन हर संप्रदाय के उत्सव को समान रूप से मनाता है। भवन में 100 से अधिक यूनिवर्सिटी छात्रों और रिसर्च स्कॉलर्स के रहने की व्यवस्था की गई है। एक्सलेंसी, भारत बांग्लादेश के साथ अपनी साझेदारी को प्राथमिकता देता है। हमें गर्व है कि भारत बांग्लादेश संबंधों को दो मित्र पड़ोसी देशों के बीच सहयोग का पूरी दुनिया के लिए एक बेहतरीन उदाहरण है। मुझे खुशी है कि हमारी आज की बातचीत से हमारे संबंधों को और भी ऊर्जा मिलेगी। जय हिंद, जय बांग्ला, जय भारत बांग्ला बंधुत्व। धन्यवाद।
Excellencies, this concludes today's ceremony.
बांग्लादेशी प्रधानमंत्री शेख हसीना और प्रधानमंत्री नरेंद्र मोदी के बीच दिल्ली में शिखर वार्ता के बाद दोनों नेता जॉइंट स्टेटमेंट जारी कर रहे थे और द्विपक्षीय संबंधों को मजबूत करने के उपायों पर इस दौरान चर्चा हुई है। परिवहन, संपर्क, क्षमता निर्माण और संस्कृति समेत 7 समझौतों पर हस्ताक्षर हुए हैं। साथ ही 3 द्विपक्षीय परियोजनाओं का भी शुभारंभ किया गया है।